heroes, and welcome back to Miscat Squad, the geeky and let's play talk show that's all about, you guys guessed it, geeky goodness and video games. My name is Cat, the crazy Overwatch fan. And I welcome you back to Miscat Squad, and today we're going to more into the lore of Hero 76, as recently, let's play the clip of me reacting to Hero 76's animation short. Uh-oh, can't get away now, boy. Can't get away now!
No,
please.
Are your strength any bomb?
No!
Whoa! Okay, she did nothing! Let her go!
Let's go!
You don't get off that easy.
Oh, he can't hear mad, he's mad, he's mad! Save her! And now we're learning about his origin story, because as you know, I want to learn as much as possible of this lore, of whatever it holds for the Overwatch fandom. That's right. Whenever I hug this pillow, it makes a squeaky sound. But yeah, guys, I for one am really excited to react to this. Why? Because there's a lot I don't know about Hero 76's backstory, and I've read some of your comments and everything. A lot of you guys were saying, like, Daddy 76, and I'm all like, he's a dead? Is he like the dead of Overwatch? And then I've read some of what you guys were saying, so I figured it would only be fitting and suitable for Miscat Squad if I went into the lore of Daddy 76, I mean, scratch that, Hero 76 origin story, to, you know, show my respect, show my support, and also learn about the character overall, because I want to learn it all. But anyway, guys, let's get started. Boy.
My name is Jack Morrison.
Jack Morrison.
People used to call me a hero.
You will always be a hero, my friend. But why 76?
I led Overwatch for 20 years.
Whoa.
We ended the Omnic crisis and paved the way to a better future. Those were the good old days. They didn't last.
Oh, no.
Bad guys popped up all over the world.
Lots
of folks said we failed to keep the world safe.
No.
Protests broke out.
I hate that.
They said that we were the problem.
Of course.
And people called for my head. They almost got their wish. It was a conspiracy. Overwatch got hit from inside and out. Our enemies blew up our headquarters.
That's not fair for them, though. They're so blamed.
And me with it. They thought I died.
Ooh.
Part of me did.
Oh, as dark as... Oh!
But the war goes on.
What?
Now, I move in secret.
Yeah,
striking
boy.
The shadows.
You go, Daddy!
All those that brought Overwatch down.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Call me a vigilante if you want. Truth is, I'm just a soldier.
Oh! Oh! Oh, man! Chills! Okay, I love him. Okay, so what I hated about this is how it's so true. This happens in real life, too. Everyone always blames the people who are trying to do good just because one thing may be going wrong. And it's like, yo, give him a break. He went through a lot, but they thought he died. And so now he moves in secret, taking down all the people who are in Overwatch. And oh, I love this. I love this. Okay, what I love about him, and it's actually Soldier 76, I apologize for calling him hero, but he's always gonna be my hero. I love about it because it's like, again, you guys were calling him like the daddy of Overwatch. I can see it now because of how he's like, I'm still gonna protect Overwatch and my children, even if I'm, you know, shunned for it. Even if Overwatch is considered bad, I'm still going to protect everyone. He's my husband. Like, that's the thing, is I want to adopt all the characters, but wow, I could totally see why he is considered that, because he's being that protective dad. He's being the protective dad over everybody, making sure that they're all okay, and oh man, but that must suck, you know? Imagine if you're, like, doing really good for, like, a country, and the world even, because, you know, Overwatch protected the world. And then just because it's like the villains pop up, everyone's all like, oh, you know, Overwatch is so stupid now. You know, they're all so stupid that they're causing us so many problems. And yo, you know, they're causing us all these problems. Hey, let's put it into the newspapers and all in the media and just shun them, shall we? And it's all like, guys, calm the motherfucking down. Why? Because, like, there's gonna be villains. I mean, it's how it always is. To have, like, that balance, it's always, if the heroes rise, so will the villains. And then there has to be, like, that balance in order to, like, keep things calm. But give Overwatch a break, man. I mean, they're just doing their jobs. You know, they're doing their jobs. Give them a break. Especially give Daddy a break. Because, you know, he needs a break. He needs a break, man. So what happened? They thought he died. Now he has to move out in secret. Oh, that's really sad. Because they won't accept him, even though, you know, he was a hero of his times, and then they were, like, shunning him. You know what I hate about it, too? It's all, like, if one person is gonna end up hating Overwatch, then they're gonna have a whole band of people, not, like, a marching band, I'm not saying like that, I'm saying, like, have a band of people just come together and be all, like, just sing their praises of defeat because they hated them, and then they're jealous, and then they don't understand. Because in reality and in real life too, it's like that's what you get. You have people who are always like, I don't understand something, so I'm gonna hate on it. I'm jealous of something, so I'm gonna hate on it. It happens everywhere. It happens on YouTube, and now it's happening in Overwatch. It happens in every fandom. It happens in real life. And what I love about this is how they kind of took where it's kind of like, Jack went through this where, you know, he was considered a hero once, but then there's gonna get those naysayers coming and they're all like, yo, we hate you, so we're gonna spread these rumors, and then we're gonna, like, praise for the villains and praise for other people who can help us out. And so, like, yo, just stop being secret admirers. Just say, hey, you know what, we actually do love you, but they don't want to say anything because that's what haters do. And yeah, Daddy 76, or whatever we call him. You guys were saying, like, Daddy 76, Daddy Soldier 76, but you guys kept saying he was the dad of Overwatch, so you know what? Give him a break. Give him a break. Those people were just jealous. The media was just jealous of you, my boy. You're cool now. I think he's fine, but I for one hope that... Oh, man, I feel bad, though. From out of everybody so far, I don't know who I would main in Overwatch. We're just gonna figure that out later on, but I might start as him because he has that great like backstory that's rich with backstory and his character development too, like how he went from hero to now guy who is in secret watching over his kids. I might main as him so far because I mean I have to see who I'm really good at, but also I want to see I just want to see all the shorts so I know who I can actually play as and also who I can support the most. But right now, he has my love and support because what he's doing, he's still watching over his kids. And that's what a good dad does. That's what a good dad does. So a round of applause for him. Let's leave some nice comments for him down below. What do you love about him? And also, what do you love about the Overwatch series? I would love to know because I'm that fan that, you know, is still discovering the internet. But also, I'm still discovering everything about Overwatch. But anyway, guys, don't forget to subscribe if you want more Miscat Squad content, especially more Overwatch content, because there's going to be a ton. I mean, a ton. And also, don't forget to give us a big fat thumbs up if you really did enjoy it. And also, don't forget to hit the bell notification, because if you don't, then you're going to miss out on Miscat Squad episodes. And I don't think if you're a fan of Miscat Squad and also Overwatch, you don't want to do that. But anyway, guys, I hope you have an amazing day. You stay safe out there. Give some support to Daddy. Give some support to him right now. Pause the video. Hug him. He needs a lot of hugs. And as always, Miscat, until the next video, embrace your fangirl and you're a fanboy every single day. Bye, guys.